the technology will always be changing. And I think that right now, there's just a lot of career opportunities that are expanding. And really, it's more like a jetpack. You are taking off, you're learning this thing and then landing over here, then taking off and learning this thing and landing over there, feeling miserable when you encounter failure.
Yep.
Don't think of it as failure. Don't think of it as an or. Think of it as, how do I better myself and become a better critical thinker?
There's no one way.
Kareem, Ryan, big question that often comes up, especially with all the noise out there. If I was starting today, or I was pivoting or deciding to make a change in my career, what should I study or what should I focus on?
Oh man, that's like, we get that question a lot. And I would just say that I always like to try to bucket it into three areas, you know? The first is, I'll get the easiest one, which is there's a lot going on in AI. And so one of the very first things that we like to talk about with people is, you know, focus in on those AI skills. If you don't know what AI is, if you don't know what an LLM is, go to Cisco U, start to learn what that is. If you are trying to build the future of the network, if you want to get into that, that's going to be a lot in AI infrastructure. Start to build up those skills. The second is security.
Yep.
I mean, there isn't a company in the world that wants an insecure network. So when we start to look at skilling, we look at how there's so much that's in networking skills that are starting to blend with security skills, where security is just starting to become like a table stake item. So, even in CCNA, there's an entire domain that's dedicated to network security. But I think people, if you really want to start going to that next step, it's understanding the cyber element of that. You know, networking security is just a component of cybersecurity.
Yep.
And so we have an entirely updated cybersecurity program. You know, our formerly called Cyber Ops certification,
yep,
is now the cybersecurity certification. We launched our ethical hacker training. I would totally recommend that. But then finally, and I think this is an area where I feel like Kareem is better to talk about, it's the network modernization skills. You know, at this event, we're going to be hearing a lot. Advancements around things like routed optical network, advancements on things, you know, we already know a lot about where Wi-Fi 7 is going. I think that one of the things about the future, when people are saying, hey, like, what are the skills that I should be building? Automation is the skill that you should be building right now. And Kareem, I feel like you can talk about this much better than I can.
I'm going to plus one everything that Ryan said for me. And it's core networking. That doesn't go away.
Yep. IP addresses are still IP addresses.
IP addresses, whether it's V4 or V6, it does not matter.
Yep.
Core networking is a skill. Network engineering in general is sexy. I know.
Especially with the AI stuff.
With the AI stuff, yep, with cloud, with,
yep,
we don't talk enough about that.
Yep.
I think when what we envision, in, you know, out there, when we envision network engineering, we think of something completely different, that like you're sitting in the background, not doing anything, CLI and, you know, connecting pipelines and whatnot. But actually, the core networking skills are needed. They're still very hot. They're still very relevant, whether you get into a cloud or maybe a cloud-based company,
yep,
or you just work on building infrastructure.
Yep.
You need that.
Yep.
And then you need that, but you can't just stop that. And you can't stop there, right? Because automation has to be hand in hand with that. So learn your coding, learn your Python,
yep,
learn how to use some of the tools from Ansible, Terraform, all of which we have all of that content for you on our platform. But these, if I were starting today,
yep,
I would get my CCNA. I would master my network engineering skills, and I would spend the time taking these skills and working on my automation skills. And that would make me the perfect network automation engineer that's needed in cloud, that's needed in AI, that's needed in just pure networking.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, David, we've talked about this, I feel like, so many times, which is, you know, back in the day, people would come to us and they were kind of hoping that skill building and careers would be like a train on a track. Like, I'm just moving, progressing, just one thing after another. And really, it's more like a jetpack. You are taking off, you're learning this thing and then landing over here, then taking off and learning this thing and landing over there. Kareem was just talking about all of these doors that you're really unlocking. getting your CCNA, building up your Python skills, being able to move into things like net DevOps, DevOps, Sec DevOps. It's really more like as you start building up these skills, you're unlocking all of these other pathways in your career. And if there is one of those doors to walk through, you know, try to focus in on where you see yourself in AI and AI infrastructure, where you see yourself in security, or, and I'll actually say, and or where you see yourself in the modern network. And I think one of the things that's the most important about this is that it's not going to be one or the other.
Yep.
It's going to be an and story. It's going to be how you collect a lot of different skills. Skilling is going to be like stamps in a passport. You're going to have this collection of places that you've been that are skills that you've collected that allow you to do more and more work. And it's going to be able to provide a lot of diversification in your career. And I feel like that is the thing that if I was to tell anybody, if I was starting over, I would be like, there's no one way. It's going to be a lot of hopping around, and it's going to be a lot of collection. And it's not going to stop. And I don't mean that in like, oh, it's not going to stop and you're going to exhaust yourself. I mean, like, it's not going to stop, and that's good.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to do it tomorrow.
Exactly.
You don't have to do it tomorrow.
Yeah, you can just be building these skills over time. Like, I feel like everybody's trying to think, oh, no, I got to know all this stuff by the end of the day or by tomorrow. And it's really, no, it's building these skills incrementally, but always continuing, you know?
And I want to just add on the incremental part of this. So CCNA does not have to be the first stop that you can. Now you can go CCST.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah.
But the CCSTs are there for you to get a taste of what it is like.
And it's free training, right?
And it's free training, and it's the certification itself is simple.
Yeah.
And so being able to just study for that, take that first step into CCST, and then maybe do security and maybe do networking.
Yeah.
And then you decide, like, okay, do I go into network engineering or do I go into security engineering? And take that next step where you can go to track to cyber ops, or you can go into your CCNA route. But all of that, it's still needed today. And all of that would actually lead you into some of the new positions and jobs that we have, and the skills that are needed in that, from AI, cloud, automation, all of that will set you up for success.
I think it's also important to highlight, right, that I always get this question, like, what should I do right now?
Yeah.
It's not like one path for everyone. And you don't just do one cert, right? You could do, because they say, should I do CCNA or something else? It's like, why don't you just do both?
Exactly.
Yeah. Or do more. Like you said, a bunch of stamps in your passport.
Yeah. It's one of these things too, where I feel like everybody looks at their career or even looks at learning as an or issue. Like, I got to do this or that. I got to make this decision or that. And really, it's always an and story. And that's, I think, the thing that has made, so, like, the people that we know that have been amazing network engineers, they're always looking at the and. They're always looking at, you know, the multiple certifications.
Yep.
Heck, even multiple CCIEs.
Yep.
And it's that curiosity that I think helps to propel you. I think right now, because of the world that we're in and because of all of these advancements, and, you know, technology is always going to be changing. You know, people are like, oh, how are jobs changing because of these next level advancements? This is the same thing that we used to hear back in 2017 with automation. The technology will always be changing. And I think that right now, there's just a lot of career opportunities that are expanding. They're not like becoming more narrow or isolated. It's more like, wow, you could really see yourself in this world, how you can use AI to do your job, or building for that, or really learning security, and more than just being reactive, but being proactive about those things in your career. The biggest thing that I would say is two items. One, find the thing that you're the most curious about, because honestly, that's going to be the thing that helps you learn in this stuff at nights, sometimes on the weekends when you're having to really like push to be able to get exam ready. But the other thing is don't wait, get started now. And don't be feeling miserable when you encounter failure.
Yep.
Failure is the greatest of teachers.
How you learn.
Yeah. And even more than that, it's like when you have those exams that don't go the way that you want, heck, you learned a lot through that process.
We've all failed exams.
Right?
Yeah, big time.
And so it's one of these things where it's important to get started. It's important to stay focused. But yeah, if I was starting out right now, I mean, finding that place in AI or security, network modernization, and then finding that collection of skills between those three that would be where I would be building my
career. There's one thing that's always overlooked too. When we talk about skills in general, I feel like we focus on technical skills, but with the progression of learning that Ryan was just talking about, with us trying different topics, taking and failing different certification, there is a skill that you build that we don't always think about, and that's critical thinking.
Good one.
And critical thinking is really, really important when in any job.
Yep.
Doesn't matter what you're doing. You're going to have that critical thinking mechanism to be able to troubleshoot, to be able to. So don't think of it as failure. Don't think of it as an or. Think of it as, how do I better myself and become a better critical thinker?
Yeah.
In a sense.
Got to ask you this question. Okay. How do I get this knowledge? Does Cisco have free places where I can learn? How do I get started?
I mean, we've got plenty of resources, right? Yep. Whether you're at just the very beginning of your career, where you're trying to figure out what you want to do with NetAcad, you have netacad.com, plenty of free resources. If you're interested in getting through the academies as a student, we have a way for you to do that. Cisco u.cisco.com. We have content for everybody, from, you know, free user all the way to subscription, you know, with our bigger investments. But if you're looking to just dabble and learn, we have free learning path. One of our network automation is an always free learning path. I think it's about 24 hours of learning of automation. We always have RevOps.
Yes.
So we have an AI RevUp, which gives you access to our latest AI infrastructure learning path up to March 24th.
That's right.
And we also have our tutorials, and we tailor the tutorials based on a lot of the feedback that we hear from our community, from where Cisco is headed in general. You know, Ryan does a really good job on keeping the team updated on the technologies that Cisco's talking about and the direction that Cisco's headed, to make sure that we have supporting learning content to support our community. And so you'll see that and reflective in our tutorials and what we release. And we're constantly, monthly, have brand new tutorials on Cisco U for you to check out.
Guys, I could keep you for a long time, but we're out of time. Thanks so much for sharing.
Hey, David, thank you so much for having us.
Thanks, David, for having us. Appreciate it.